Hey guys, we are at Coral Castle in Florida, and in this video, let's take a look at the sundial. Coral Castle is a very mysterious place because it was built single-handedly by a man called Ed around 1920. Here is the sundial that he created, and it has some very complex features, and it's also unique because it is the only megalithic sundial in the world, and it weighs around 6 to 8 tons. The base of the sundial is made of a massive coral rock with a polished concave top, which is finished with lime mortar to make it smooth and bright. On top, there is a piece of metal sticking out of another large rock. A shadow is cast off of this metal and falls on this bowl. If you draw lines at the center of these figure eights, the shadow will fall accurately on these lines from 9 a.m., 9:30, 10, 10:30, 11, 11:30, and so on. For example, you can see that the shadow was falling exactly on this line here. So, what's the time now? It is exactly 11:30. This shadow will gradually move and reach 12 noon and will be here in 30 minutes. This sundial can only tell time between 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., but it is accurate down to the minute. Now, every civilization has had sundials which can tell time, but Ed wanted to push the limits and show the world that he could make things really complicated. So he made it into a calendar that shows the current month and all four seasons accurately. But why put these figure eights all over the bowl? Why not just draw lines? Each closed curve is an abstract astronomical concept called analemma. To put it simply, if you take a picture of the sun from the same location every day at a certain time for a whole year, the sun's apparent path will be an analemma. This is due to the elliptical orbit of the Earth and the tilt of Earth's axis. This is a very abstract technical concept, but Ed used this to show the seasons and the current month. For example, if you look at the sundial at noon on winter solstice, which is the first day of winter, the shadow will be right here at the top. So if you see the shadow right down at the bottom, what does it mean? It means summer solstice or the first day of summer. And with the same technique, you can also calculate the spring and fall equinox around the center of the analemma. By following the path of the curve, you can also tell the current month. Watch the hand. June 21, July, August, September, October, November, December. After December 21, the days become longer. January, February, March, April, May, and June. But how could Ed come up with a complex sundial like this with a fourth grade education? Ed often claimed that he knew the secret behind the construction of the Great Pyramid in Egypt. Was this just a marketing gimmick, or did he really tap into the forbidden ancient knowledge? Now, guess where the oldest sundial comes from? It is from Egypt, believe it or not, and it was built 3,500 years ago. If that's not enough, you can see the similarity between the oldest sundial and the sundial at Coral Castle. Is this just a coincidence? This sundial shows standard time and not daylight saving time because Ed built the sundial before 1918 when the daylight saving time was first implemented in the US. However, you could simply change these numbers on the sundial, just like adjusting our regular clocks, and it would work. Why was this rock carved into a concave structure? Is its curvature related to the horizon and our planet's curvature? Now, remember, this rock at the bottom is made of a massive coral rock that weighs at least 3 tons. If Ed had made a single mistake, he would have to start working on quarrying another 3-ton rock all by himself. So, where did he get this amazing skill and knowledge from? And how could he come up with these complex astronomical calculations with a 4th grade education? In fact, I believe we still don't know the complete use of this artifact, because you can see multiple slots and other stones placed around this sundial, and we don't know what they are used for. Also, why would you put this massive stone just to have a small piece of metal sticking out of it? I hope you like this video. I'm finding a lot of intriguing stuff like this, so please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and talk to you soon.